I was so surprised by looking at the notes when you say you are actually busier during the pandemic, completely the opposite of what I would expect. How is that possible?
Possible because the high luxury companies are very well financed. They don't have capital problems. When they see an opportunity like closings because of coronavirus, they increase the number of store fix-ups. So we actually doubled our volume of store renovations compared to normal times when business is opened.
I mean, I guess the idea was to do whatever you can while you had the opportunity to do it to prepare for the other side of the pandemic. And I'm looking at whether it's Louis Vuitton and Dubai, and all of these are stores that you were involved with and are involved with. Louis Vuitton, Dubai, Louis Vuitton in Japan, Bulgari and Place Vendôme in Paris, Chanel in multiple locations as well. Is that sort of the strategy? Do what you can while you're closed so that you're ready for the flux of people on the other side?
100%. As I said, the well-financed high luxury brands are in positions to move quickly when store closings happen. And they have very large and professional store planning departments, and they're well capitalized. So the idea of going to sleep during coronavirus is the opposite of what they do. They want to be wide awake now as the stores are opening. They also have an enormous transfer of merchandise, you know. They're very quick, because we were talking about supply chain issues. They're very quick. If all the stores in France are closed for 6 months, where does the merchandise go? Well, it goes to China, because China was opened. And the Chinese stopped traveling to Europe, and everyone thought, oh my goodness, all of these companies are going to have a 30% drop in sales. Well, they did in Europe, but in China, they had a 40% increase in sales. So where do you think they make their money?
Yeah. I'm also thinking about, as you say, supply chain, the stores that you design are beautiful. They cost a lot of money, obviously, and they don't look like many of your typical retail stores. I can only imagine what it costs to build and design one of the stores for Chanel or any of the other luxury brands that you do. Is it a challenge to get some of the materials that you need, which come from far, far away places, which cost a lot more money perhaps than your run-of-the-mill product?
Construction has been a nightmare during the coronavirus epidemic, a real nightmare. You can't get electrical fixtures. I mean, you can't even get electrical plugs, not to mention marble imported from Italy since Carrara was closed for 6 months. The supply chain has been very, very, very difficult, and you have to switch to local resources much more than normal. We also normally have, for instance, all of the cabinetry built in Europe and shipped all over the world. Shipping, as you know, I mean, it's a joke in our industry. Why is the store opening 8 weeks late and they still go Suez Canal? I mean, you can't catch up. Shipping is really 8 weeks behind, and it's forced us to switch to local resourcing much more than we normally do.
You must also have a pretty good read on where real inflation is, given the materials that you need for what you do.
Construction materials are going through the roof. It is very difficult to get labor. And it's not just in construction, but it's in the production of the product. Remember, if France was closed in a lockdown for 6 months, there was nobody hand-making pocketbooks. That's a real problem to stock the stores with. I've been opening stores with much less merchandise than normal. And this conversely has created a sort of what I call hysterical demand for the product. When we opened Washington, D.C., Chanel, customers flew from Dallas, from Atlanta, from Chicago, saying, I want the new product, I want the new product. And very hard to keep our stores stocked. That conversely has produced a great deal of profit for them. They have zero extra inventory, which has never happened.